Google Drive, Dropbox, iCloud, you know what they all have in common? Some will probably concur that they're all subscription-based cloud storage options, right? Well, that's true. But the thing these three have in common is that they all make me want to die a little inside whenever I get that monthly charge, like a tiny subscription vampire slowly draining my bank account. Alas, it was an annoyance I deemed necessary. Until now. Have you ever heard of a thing called a NAS? Well, I did it until recently. Then Ugreen gave me a pitch. Now, imagine your own server. Whoa, I'm gonna have to stop you there. Server, you're losing me, man. When I think of server, I'm thinking of a large, dusty, expensive, complicated rectangle that makes loud noises. No thank you. What if I told you it's none of that? Oh? Imagine having cloud storage, but locally. So no more subscription fees, all for an affordable price.
I'm listening.
You can access it from all of your devices securely. You can even share files with others. Works great for backups too. Even Time Machine backup for Macs? Even Time Machine backup for Macs. Hey man, I have a lot of shows, movies, cat photos, manga. It can support up to 60 terabytes. That's like 40,000 movies. How many cat photos though? 20 million. This thing uses drives, right? What's the catch? No funny business? No funny business. It supports third-party drives. We even have a compatibility list. Huh. And no super large rectangle? No. Some might say it looks quite sleek. I have the IQ and attention span of a toddler. We have a simple step-by-step guide. It'll take 10 minutes of your time to set up. Well, Ugreen, you had me at everything you just said. Let's do it. Sup, Rotten? I'm gonna pretend I'm a network admin now, but the idea of having my own little storage island, private, local, and not hostage to the next price hike feels like a tiny revolution. Less subscription anxiety, more control, and the satisfying thought of physically touching my backups instead of just imagining them floating in someone else's server farm. So today, I'm unboxing the Ugreen NAS DH2300, learning how to set it up, and finding out how much of this actually lives up to the hype for a total novice. Will it be an answer to my problem? There's only one way to find out. All of my thoughts are my own. Now, let's unbox it. So in the box, we have a quick start guide, a 2-year warranty. Wow. Some user instruction. We have a couple screws. We have a screwdriver, some sort of cable. What is this? Oh, an Ethernet cable. Oh, and the power adapter. Now let's see the actual NAS. Ooh. Oh, this is sleek. Oh, wow. This is like surprisingly light. I love the color. I was afraid it was going to be white, like all white. And that's not really my style. This definitely is more my style. This is the power button. And so for LAN, disk one, disk two, USB-C. Yeah, this is a 2-disk drive. A 2-disk NAS. Or 2-drive NAS. I am in foreign waters right now. Bear with me. And then on the back, it has 2 USB-C A ports that support USB 3.2, LAN for Ethernet, an HDMI port, and a port for the power adapter. So we can open it. Ooh. So this is where the drives will go. Okay. Let's put that back. Oh, it's when you move it together, kind of just snaps in. So that's cool. Can I like turn it upside down? Oh, I can. I mean, I don't know why you would want to, honestly, but hey, black shoes, calm down. Ooh, and Western Digital 4 terabyte drives. I usually skip instructions and like, I can figure it out. But like, I feel like for this, I just got to be very careful, you know? I'll do drive number one and open up one of these bad boys. This is gorgeous, man. Place it like this. Then start screwing. Both drives are securely in the drive tray. Now I just put them back. And you. Ooh, a very satisfying sound. Then I just throw you on top. And that's it. That setup was extremely straightforward and very clear. Thank you, Ugreen, for idiots like me. So the beauty of this NAS is that you can access it from basically any device.
including initiating setup with just using NFC on your iPhone. This thing doesn't recognize Wi-Fi, so you have to connect it to your router using the Ethernet cable provided. Just keep that in mind. From here, you set up your NAS by naming it, creating your account, and binding it to your email address so you'll be able to access it from all your devices. From there, initialization starts and your NAS starts setting everything up. And then voila, you're in. The next step is setting up your drives. You can still do this on your phone, but I'm going to continue to set up on my Mac for the sake of the video. From here, you select both of your drives and set up a RAID type. Now, RAID types can get pretty complicated, but because we only have a 2-bay NAS, we're pretty limited in what we can do in our options. However, RAID 1 is definitely the most solid pick here, and it's even recommended by Ugreen themselves. How RAID 1 works is that you use one drive for your data, and then the other one mirrors the data on your original drive. Therefore, if one of them fails, your data will still be protected because it's still on the other drive. You're basically using one slot for a failsafe. And you know, since you'll start putting your files on here, you don't want it to get corrupted. So this is the safest choice for setting up your NAS. From there, you select your preferred file system, put in your password for confirmation, and then boom, your NAS will now take a bit to set up your drives, and then you can just do whatever you want. What I recommend is downloading the apps Ugreen has provided. Now, these apps vary from backing up your system, like you can set it up to have it back up your iPhone and your Mac automatically, to storing your music, like so. Cue that Persona 5 soundtrack. I recommend just looking through all of them and seeing what appeals to you. For me, I've just been storing YouTube videos that I've completed, uploaded my entire manga library that I've been collecting over the years, and started going through my images to begin to store those too. For the theater app, I was able to move my shows and movies because with the Ugreen NAS, you can fix the transfer speed issue to move files fast and effortlessly. Equipped with a 1 gigabit Ethernet network port, the speed is up to 125 megabits per second. It can transfer a 1 gigabyte file in just several seconds. I don't have gigabit internet, but the ideal speed can reach what the pic above shows. Moving my TV shows and movies was a breeze. Now, here's a quick tutorial on how to automatically back up your iPhone and back up your Time Machine backup, as mentioned earlier. On your iPhone, go to your Ugreen NAS app, head to the Photos app, press Tools on the bottom right corner, and hit Album Backup. From there, you hit the Album Backup toggle, and then you'd be shown a prompt. Hit Allow Full Access, and then it will start automatically backing up immediately. And you can even press it to see the progress very fast. And then from there, I want you to go to your sync and backup app and turn on the auto backup and background option, so it'll back up as you continue to use your phone. Now for your Mac backup, head to the Ugreen NAS app on your Mac, click the Control Panel app, and hit File Service. From there, click Advanced Settings and enable Bonjour Service. Hit Apply. After that's done, you click Set Time Machine Folder. You create a new shared folder and name the folder whatever you want. In my case, I name it Time Machine Backups. Hit Create, and once you give yourself read and write admin settings, you hit OK. Back in Control Panel, set your Time Machine folder and set it to the folder you just made and hit Save. From there, you hit Apply. And now go into your Mac settings, go to General and scroll down till you see Time Machine Backups and click that. From there, you press the little plus button and you should see Time Machine Backups, or whatever you decided to name your folder, as one of the options. You hit that and click Setup Disk. From there, you type in a login for your NAS and hit Connect. And then you'll be given a prompt to encrypt your backup. You create a brand new password and then re-enter that password for your backup and then hit Done. And that's it. It'll show you when it'll start the next backup and you're good to go. So be sure to check the description below and use the code to get 20% off. Get off a cloud and get on NAS. It's great over here. I can't stress this enough. I am extremely new to this, and I know I'm not using the NAS or its apps to their fullest capabilities. One day, though, I hope to revisit this once I'm more acquainted and give you an update if that's what you guys would want to see. But so far, me likey. Me likey a lot. What do you think about the NAS? Do you see yourself getting one? Do you already have one? Let me know in the comments. And if you'd like to support the channel, check out my Patreon, where you get exclusive perks like getting access to videos early, getting your own Rotten avatar made, and more, along with my Rotten and Rotten Pro subscribers, Vasco, Francisco Beck, and Miss Game. Thank you all for the support, as it keeps me dropping videos consistently, and thank you, viewer, for watching. If you want to see more of me, you know what to do. Don't get me wrong, I'm not completely against subscription models, but I feel like it should be for more recreational or productivity-based stuff. So when you cancel, it's like, oh, whatever. But like when it comes to things like data, that shouldn't be a luxury. Oh, so you're telling me if I don't give you that payment in October, then my entire history is gone? That's not crazy to you?